Dear students, welcome to our class on Agricultural Meteorology 22. The first bit of the today's class is the fluxes of short and long wave radiations emanating from a surface depends largely on its dash type of the surface. Short wave radiation up to 3 microns, in some books it is 4 microns, long wave radiation from 4 to 80, in some books it may be 100. But please remember that both are influenced by type of the surface. Now, for agrometeorological studies, the PAR may be taken as a dash of solar radiation. 45% of the solar radiation is the PAR, photosynthetic reactive radiation. Now, crop yield is ultimately, this is the duty of agriculture meteorologists. Crop yield is ultimately photosynthetic production and respiratory consumption of dry matter. Anything, fill in the blank may come. Now, in agrometeorological studies of photosynthesis, the term dash is used instead of solar radiation. Usually, we the agrometeorologists use light intensity. This bit has come at least twice in the last 4 exams. Saturation light, this also bit has come. Saturation light intensity is the minimum light intensity at which the rate of photosynthetic process reaches maximum value. Anything may come as a bit. Okay, so saturation light intensity is the minimum light intensity where photosynthesis reaches its maximum value. Now, the response of crops to a given meteorological factor, solar radiation, temperature, humidity, anything, is affected by dash two things. Number one, growth stage. Number two, physiology of the crop. Growth stage and physiology of anything may come in the bits. An example of most efficient user of sunlight is maize. If maize is not given, it is sorghum. Most efficient user of sunlight is maize. Next choice is sorghum. Wheat is a more efficient user of dash than rice. CO2. Wheat is CO2. The least efficient user of CO2 is dash, maize. Please note, refer to our climate change, agrometeorology, farmers, and that's why I request you, please subscribe to our channel, like it, and share it. Now, solar radiation from dash stage to maturity, dash stage to maturity is linearly related to yield in rice crop. It is a panicle initiation stage. The net primary production of crop is proportional to, please see in all the growth models, DSAT, traditional models, latest models, the crop growth is directly proportional to intercepted PAR, IPAR. Now, so let us see few more bits. Closely spaced isobars indicate dash change of pressure in the direction right angles to the isobars, rapid or steep. Closely spaced, widely spaced isobars indicate weak pressure gradient. Okay, the isobars dash at any time, never crosses at any time. The winds are the result of horizontal pressure gradient dash. Okay, the winds are the result of dash, horizontal pressure gradient. Air its motion is known as wind. Okay, so gradient, pressure gradient is there. Now, the primary cause of air movement is the development of a horizontal pressure gradient developed due to temperature changes. So this bit will come. So last two most important bits of today's class are, when the pressure gradient force and Coriolis force are in opposite idealized balance. Okay, in an opposite the idealized balance of flow, it is known as a geostropic wind. The last bit is the wind that results, wonderful bit, the wind that results from a balance of pressure gradient, centrifugal and Coriolis force is known as a gradient wind. Thank you.